others, praise God, none other than Evangelist Tanya Randall, that's going to come before you today and speak the word of God to you today, that we all can be able to be blessed. I'm sitting right here and I ain't going nowhere. So this is being able to, as we all stand and just give accolade to her right now. Randall! Yeah!
Glory! 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 Kings. He is still the Lord of Lords. A great and mighty I am. Woo! Without him, we could do nothing. And the greatest thing about it is that there'll never be another. Woo! He said, I am the first and the last, the Alpha and the Omega. Woo! It's certain small, simple things that just keep you smiling, just to know that he is your great I am. Of being established, God said there's something that needs to happen in order to be established. You can't just take on one attribute and you still holding on to the other. Hold your places right there and go to Philippians. Go to Philippians, and then I want to show you something. Prepare me a body. Philippians chapter number 2. I need, glory to God, these two chairs right here. Yep, right on the opposite side of that. Philippians chapter number 2, and beginning at verse number 4. Now, remember what we just read in Hebrews, because we are going to go back to Hebrews. But Philippians chapter number 2 and verse number 4, it says, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Look not to every man on his own things. This is where we keep getting messed up in the body of Christ. We're looking to ourselves for our solutions. And y'all done heard Apostle preach this probably all last month, talking about the situation that he came up against with his lights. And the first thing that he kept saying is that I look to myself first. And see, don't tell me that we, as being saved, we don't turn around and begin to come back to identify with. Come sit right here with me real quick. All day, I could sit here and do this. And this is how we are. We just complimenting ourselves. And all people see is a shadow of everything to come. Now you stop, because you're going to be God. After a while, it gets to a point where God is tired of our stuff. And then we're still looking for manifestations to happen in our life. But I'm doing it all by myself. Where is that? And let me get my Bible. Pass me that Bible. Because why are you doing that and just sitting there? This is God. Now I'm looking at my image. This is my image. Because I'm made in the image and the likeness of him. However, when God gets tired of the nonsense that we go through, the very image that was replicating me, the very image that's right before me that I see on a consistent, I keep going over and over. But now it comes to a point where God said, either you're going to be saved or either you're going to be a son of me. Because a body prepared means that this body dies. But if I'm still alive, Christ said, I died for you. I died and took habitation. So you can't do the things that you want to do. So God said, I need an example. I need a body prepared. So now when I act up and I'm trying to do all the things, I'm trying to get upset, I'm trying to get angry, God said, I'm not sending forth those same frequencies back to you, because I don't want you to think that it's all right. The next verse says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant. Took on the form of a servant to show me that I don't have to lose control. To show me that there's something greater that he wants from about me. To show me that there is greatness in me. But I just have to tap into it. I can't do what I want to do. But I've got to be still and know that he is God. And the God that he is dwells in me. But wait. But made himself of no reputation and took on the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. Hold on. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. You've got to die to some stuff. If you don't die to the things that are going on around you, God will continually send forth his son that it would be just an image to you and not an indwelling, not a relationship. It will just look like a shadow of what you could possibly become, of what you could possibly take a here to, but yet not to actually have the ability of it because you refuse to let yourself go. Back to your seat because we're going to revisit this in a minute. Just keep looking in the mirror, y'all. He said he became obedient even unto death, even the death of the cross. Now, I looked at this thing and I said, God, this is deeper than what it is. Not just the death of Christ dying, but the death of the things in us that ought to take on the ability to die and we not go back and dig it up and resurrect it. Because see, every time we cause something to resurrect in our life, we begin to start looking in the mirror again. And that image begins to do what we do. But it's when those things die. He said he became obedient to it. You've got to let it go. Because if I let it go, now the image that stands before me is the image that I now duplicate. So when I duplicate it, there's greater things. There's greater mindset. As we said, preparing the body. The mind changes first. I don't think on the things that cause me heartache, but I think on the things that bring me life. I think on the things that my father thought of. I think on the things that I'm able to do exceedingly and abundantly in. And it doesn't prohibit me nor limit me because my own natural being will keep me isolated. But the mind of Christ will take me to places.